What opens with a montage, my favorite word, of culturally insensitive events on college campuses in alignment with, I don't know, a Dear Black People, Release Your Inner Negro party, and what closes with Mr. Lionel masturbating with a new haircut. He ain't fro no more. If you guess Dear White People Chapter 2, then you're correct. Speaking of montages, this is totally off the subject, but I saw a montage this morning of number 45, and what was he talking about? Classified information. And it was just, I love a montage. Montages are very effective, and a very effective way of illustrating certain points. Wouldn't you agree? Okay, so we're on chapter 2 of Dear White People. That's basically it. The whole episode was about Mr. Lionel, more or less. And it seems like they're not advancing the story in terms of where we left off with the last chapter. We're just getting that story from a different perspective. There is some advancement, but we haven't just moved away far in time. Okay, so Mr. Lionel is popping and popular now. Pop, 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 pow, Mr. Lionel. Now that he let Black folks know about the Dear White People party, and he wrote about Ebony and Ivy on the cover of whatever newspaper they have at school. We see a scene where Lionel hears his roommate having sex and he masturbates. And when he's imagining what's going on behind the wall that he can hear but can't see, we notice, or I notice, that he is very focused on his roommate, the man. And so it's like, I guess I'm like, oh, he's gay. He's gay. And then we see a little thing where his new editor at the newspaper that he works at as a student has assumed that he's gay. And he says the editor is guessing correctly that Lionel is at the crush on your straight roommate phase after Lionel asserts that he does not believe in labels. So I don't know if he's gay, but he seemed to be into his male roommate. Okay, so then we see that Lionel notices that, not Coco, but baby girl Sam is not interested in going after Pastiche, who had this Dear Black People party. And he's wondering why. We already know because we saw chapter 1. So we know what's up. She ain't interested in going after them because she the one that did it. And then we see Lionel at a theater party that he's been invited to by his editor. And his editor has suggested, look, man, search for your label. So he's searching for his label after searching literally gayness of masturbating to straight roommate on Google. He was Googling it. So he ends up, you know, interacting with this guy and this couple kind of, and their roommates, and he ends up going back to their place and they invite him into a threesome, and Lionel cracks up and he outs them as a gay man and a fag hag. Like, why y'all pretending it's a threesome? You just want to have sex with me. So I thought that was interesting how clear he could see it. And it was kind of a funny scene to me. The editor, all during the party, while he was at the party, has been texting him and reaching out to him, calling, you know, Lionel. And Lionel, I guess after he decides he don't want to have this fake threesome with this couple, he goes into the office. And the editor has accessed investigations, or has access to some interviews that the dean has been doing as they are investigating this Dear White People party. And, you know, with different students about the Pastiche party. So, Lionel is looking at the different people who have been interviewed. He zooms in on Sam because he had that feeling that something wasn't quite what it seemed to be. And so, he realizes from listening to that interview that she is the one who, you know, leaked the invite that had been canceled for the Dear Black People party. And then we see him telling Sam that he knows that she leaked the invite. And we had seen that on the last episode. So then we hear more roommate sex through the walls. And I feel like this is the third time, but I only have it written down twice. So I don't know if this is just in his mind or if his roommate is having quite a bit of sex through those walls. Because this one woman who comes up to him, I think it's Coco, and she asking all about the roommate, and you know, he's like, I don't have any information, but he does. His roommate is seems to be getting it in, literally getting it in. His roommate, what's his roommate's name? I don't know, but he's the guy from the movie whose father was a dean at the school. Who had dealt with Sam before. So then, and he takes the moment of after his roommate has come to the conclusion, he's come to the conclusion of his sexual encounter. He takes that moment to knock on the wall and ask his roommate, to give him a haircut, because his roommate had let him know, you know, I cut hair, I can cut your hair for you. So he confesses his gayness to an empty room, because since he's become popular, you know, there was one scene where his roommate was like, you gonna get all the females. He doesn't use that language, but so anyway, so I guess his roommate, as he's about to cut him, is, you know, what's your number, and you know, for you do a 2 or 3 or 1, what size? You, the little boy don't know, he don't know what his number is for getting his haircut. I barely know. I think I like a 1. Do I like a 0? Because I'm about to get all of this shaved off. I think I'm gonna get somebody to do it. So he confesses, you know, with guys like, if you've been having a lot of sex, a lot of women, all this going on. And he says, look, man, you know, I'm gay. He confesses his gayness, but he doesn't realize it's an empty room. So there's like a moment when he realizes that he confessed to an empty room, and we're like, is he going to really confess? And then he really confesses. He tells his roommate, hey, you know, I'm gay. His roommate's name is Troy. So he says it to Troy, and Troy literally don't trip. I mean, he don't trip over his words or nothing. He just smooth and easy, go on with the conversation. It's no big deal. So that was Dear White People Chapter 2. Thank you for watching. I am Angela, and the channel is Be Fabulous You, all one word, all spelled out. And I am also Be Fabulous You on Twitter, and you can probably find me by Be Fabulous You on Facebook if you was really, really looking for me. And that's it. That's what I got. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here, sharing, subscribing, liking, and all of that other stuff. Remember, fabulous one, be you, be fabulous, be fabulous you. Peace.